Hello guys, this is Shubhabrata and welcome back to my channel Circuit Asian. As you have seen, the main entrance of my house is next to my workshop. And when someone comes to my house, I have to open and close the gate most of the time. And this is very distracting for me and the kind of work I do. So for that, I built a gate lock system which is based on IoT and RFID technology. And if you want to know that how I built the system, then don't skip the video, watch till the end. Let's get started. Before moving further into the video, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, so do it right now. It is free for you, but it's helped me a lot and excites me to create such content. Before building the physical device, we need to know the each and every component of the system. To know the each and every component, first I will write down the features of my device. First, we will have a RFID scanner which will scan any type of RFID card or FOB tags. Next, we have a door lock mechanism. My door lock mechanism is based on a servo motor, but this door lock mechanism can be based on any solenoid lock, any motorized actuator or any type of pneumatic actuators also. Third, we will have a voice-based notification system, which will allow us to get the status of the device with the help of voice, and which will make my device more attractive. Fourth feature of my device is internet connectivity. My device will be connected to the internet, so the status of the device can be accessed through internet from a remote location, and the lock also be controlled via the internet connectivity. And for controlling the gate lock system or getting the status of the device, we will also develop the Android application. So these five are the features of my device. Let's have a look on the block diagram of the system. First, we have the microcontroller unit. As I have said before that my device will have internet connectivity, so I am using ESP32 development module as a microcontroller unit. Next, we need a RFID scanner. Here I am using RC522 RFID module, and this module communicates to the microcontroller using SPI communication. Next, I have the gate lock mechanism, which is basically based on a servo motor, and the servo motor I am using, that is MG995 metal geared servo, and I am also using some limit switches to limit the opening and closing position of the servo motor. Then we have this indicator system. Basically we have two type of indicator. One is the LED indicator, where I am using some 3mm LEDs and also a NeoPixel LED. And another indicating system is the sound indication system, which I have said before. And for this sound indication system, I am using the DF Player Mini. And I have already made a video about DF Player Mini. So if you want to watch it out and want to know more about DF Player Mini, you can watch that video. Link is given in the description. And to keep track of the time, we also need a RTC module. So I am using DS1307. Next, we have a switch based input system. We are using TTP223 touch module sensor as a input switch. By using one of the switch, you can open the gate from the inside, and using another switch, you can add new card to the systems. And finally, we need a power supply to power up the system. I am using a 12 volt DC adapter to power up the system, and then I am converting this 12 volt into 5 volt and 3.3 volt to distribute into the circuit. As you have seen that my main entrance is in outdoor, that means if I mount all the electronic devices without any protection in the outside, then it can be a disaster while it's raining. I am using total 5 boxes based on the indoor and outdoor. The first box, which will have the power supply, the microcontroller unit, that is ESP32, and the DF player mini, it will be inside of my workshop, and the rest of these 4 boxes will be outside. So the second box will consist of the RFID module with some indicating LEDs for showing that the RFID card access is granted or denied. Then we will have the input switch section box, where I have mounted 2 touch switches, and I will connect all the sensors. Like basically I'm using a read switch sensor for alignment of the gate and some limit switches for the opening and closing position of the servo based gate lock mechanism. So all the sensor wires will be connected in this switch box. The fourth box will consist of a 3-watt speaker and a PAM8403 amplifier module, which will amplify the signal which is coming from the main controller box. And the last box is for the servo. As we are using a very long cable for the servo motor, so if I send 5 volt through this cable, it can be dropped and it can be affect operation of the motor. So I am sending 12 volt through the servo cable and converting it into 5 volt near to the servo motor, so the voltage will be exactly 5 volt. So for that reason, I am keeping the 7805 regulator and the filtering capacitor inside this box. And in this box, the servo cable will also connect. So this is our circuit diagram. First, we have the microcontroller section. So as a microcontroller, we are using ESP32. And this DF player mini is connected to ESP32 via UART communication. The RX pin of the DF player mini is connected to TX2, and the TX pin of the DF player mini is connected to RX2, which is basically 16 and 17 number pin of ESP32. And the busy pin of the DF player mini is connected to D15 or 15 number pin of ESP32. Because we don't want to play the next music until the previous music is played. So for that functionality, we are using this busy pin. Next, we have the power section. In the power section, there are 3 parts. The first part is a 5 volt regulator section. We are using a 7805 regulator to convert the 12 volt power, which is coming from the adapter, to convert into 5 volt. And this 5 volt will be used in the amplifier section. And this amplifier will be attached to our speaker. Next, we have a 3.3 volt section, where we are using a LDV33 voltage regulator because its current capability is high and DF player mini needs more power to drive the speaker. So we are using this voltage regulator instead of AMS1117. We have used a 470 microfarad capacitor at the output of this voltage regulator to stable out the voltage. Next, we have the buck converter section. This buck converter will convert this 12 volt into 5 volt, and this power will be used for the ESP32 and the other modules like RFID modules, all the LED lights and the RTC modules. As a buck converter, we are using MC34063IC. I am using this IC because we need few components to make this buck converter. First, we need a 0.33 ohm resistor as a shunt resistor. As I don't have a 0.33 ohm resistor, I have used 3 1 ohm resistor in parallel connection. At the output, we have a freewheeling diode, a inductor capacitor filter section, and a feedback resistance to maintain the output voltage. Here I am using a 10 kilo ohm preset to adjust the voltage to exact 5 volt. And we are also using a 470 picofarad capacitor to control the buck converter frequency. This is the relay section. I am using a 2CO relay to cut off the positive and negative, the plus and ground power of the servo, because I don't want to activate the servo all the time when the servo motor is not in operation. So we are using this relay, and there is a diode for freewheeling purpose for the relay coil, and we have also a transistor BC547 to control this 5V relay. And we have this last section, that is connector section. Basically, there are 2-pin, 3-pin, 4-pin, 5-pin and 6-pin connectors for connecting the other switch boxes or the RFID boxes to the main controller. So we are using these JST pin terminals. Beside this controller circuit, we have also designed two another circuit. One is this RFID circuit, where I have used a AMS 1117 3.3V regulator to power up the RFID module, and in this circuit we have three LEDs, one for the power indication, which is the yellow color LED, and the green LED is for the access granted status, and the red LED for the access denied status. So here we have the RFID module, these three LED with its current limiting resistance, and the AMS 1117 3.3V voltage regulator with its capacitor at the input and the output. And our third and last circuit is the switchbox circuit, where I have used two touch switches for adding card and for opening the gate from the inside. So here we have two touch switches, TTP223, and we have a AMS 1117 voltage regulator for powering up the touch switches, and we have several LEDs for each limit switch and the read switch for indication purpose, so we can understand the status of each and every switches without connecting the microcontroller into the laptop or PC. So here we have total 6 LEDs with its current limiting resistor, AMS 1117 voltage regulator with its input output capacitor, and two touch switches. And these green things are basically pads, where we will connect the wire directly. Basically, we will solder the wires to the pad directly. We don't have any connector in these circuits. So now I will show you the PCBs. Now let's have a look in the 3D model of the PCB. So this is our PCB. There you can see the ESP32, DF player mini, the relay section, buck converter section, and all other the connectors. And now let's have a look on the RFID PCB. So this is the RFID PCB, and these all are the pads where we will solder the wire directly. Here is the connector for the RFID module. And here are three LEDs, yellow, green, and red LED. And now this is the PCB for the switch boxes. Here are two touch switches, and these all are the pads where we will solder the wire directly. We have the pads in this circuit in the both side, left and right. And here is the AMS 1117 connector. Let's also look in the 3D design of these PCBs. So the touch switches will be little upper. I will make that using headers. And these all are the LEDs, and these golden colored things are the pads. Okay, and also have a look the 3D design of the RFID PCB. So this is our RFID PCB. It will look like this. These golden colored things are pads. Here is the yellow, green, and red LED for indication purpose. So that is it for the circuit and the PCB. So this was the part 1 of our IoT-based RFID gate lock project. In the next part, we will show you the assembly process and the installation process. So stay tuned for that, and if you guys love this video, then make sure you hit the like button and share this video with your friends and technical community. And if you have any question, then comment down below. And if you are new to this channel or seeing me for the first time, then make sure you hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. And if you want to support our effort, then you can buy me a coffee. Link is given in the description. And the most important thing, be creative.